By the end of this video, you're going to understand the difference between FlutterFlow and Bubble, and hopefully know which no-code tool you want to use in your next project. So FlutterFlow and Bubble are both no-code tools that allow you to build web applications without writing any code. One of the big differences between FlutterFlow and Bubble is Bubble integrates the database into the no-code tool. So when you're building in Bubble, you're going to build the front end, you're going to build the logic, and you're going to store your data all in Bubble. So it takes care of all of that for you, which makes it a little bit easier to get started with and a little easier to build in. FlutterFlow, on the other hand, doesn't take care of the back end integrated into the tool directly. You're going to use a separate back end such as Supabase or Firebase, which allows you to store your database separately, and then you're going to have to connect it to your FlutterFlow application. So this makes it a little bit more complicated to get started and build in, but it also has the benefit of having your database separated from your FlutterFlow app, which is actually kind of helpful if you ever want to, you know, move your app to a different service. Let's say you want to eventually move to code in the future. For some reason, you don't want to use FlutterFlow anymore. Your database is on a separate platform, which can be really helpful. So that can be a pro of FlutterFlow, but it also can be a con because it's a little bit trickier to build in. So something to be aware of right off the bat is the way that your data is stored on each of these platforms. The other thing off the bat to be aware of between the difference between FlutterFlow and Bubble is that FlutterFlow currently allows you to publish your app directly into the Apple App Store or the Google Play Store, and it's you can turn it into an app that someone can download on their mobile phone. Now, Bubble has announced that they are building this functionality into the no-code tool, and they haven't said exactly when it's going to be released yet. Maybe by the time you're watching this video, they have released that, and you can now upload your app into the App Store from Bubble. But as of now, as of January 2024, you can only do that with FlutterFlow directly from the platform. Now, there are wrappers that you can use to essentially wrap your app in Bubble. If you Google you know, App Store wrapper for Bubble, you'll be able to find some solutions, which is going to allow you to essentially wrap your app and publish it into an App Store. So there is a way to do it, but it's not going to probably perform as well currently as FlutterFlow will for that. So something to be aware of between the difference between FlutterFlow and Bubble there. On the other hand, Bubble is built natively to build web apps. So it's really, really good at building web apps. A web app is an application that you just access from a web browser, whether it is a mobile web browser or a phone web browser. And FlutterFlow, on the other hand, is, as you can even see from their kind of first image here on their homepage, it's more optimized for a phone app, for a native app. So you want to think about what kind of app do you want to build. If you're totally okay just building a web app and that's going to solve the problem that you're building for most of your users, then Bubble might be the tool that you want to consider there. So just kind of keep that in mind between whether you want to build a web app or whether it's really important for you to build a native app that someone can download on their phone. Now, FlutterFlow can also build web apps. So kind of just like I had mentioned before, how Bubble, there's ways to build, iPhone apps that you can download onto your phone. FlutterFlow has this functionality too for web apps. So it doesn't mean that you can't use FlutterFlow for that if you want to. The next thing that I want to talk about is the community of each of these no-code tools. So they both have really strong communities. And the reason that this is important is, let's say you're building in either of these tools and you run into an issue. One thing that you're going to want to do is search in their community forums, see if anyone's asked the question before that you're dealing with, or you can ask the question yourself if it's new and get an answer from the community. This is really helpful with any no-code tool that you are using. Both of these tools have really strong communities, so I would say it's really a tie there in terms of which community is going to be stronger. Bubble has been around a little bit longer, so there might be more questions already answered in their forums. For example, But FlutterFlow, again, does have a very strong community as well. Okay, pricing. This is something that you are probably really curious about. So the pricing is different for both FlutterFlow and Bubble. And part of this also reflects the fact that Bubble has integrated the database into the product, whereas FlutterFlow separates out kind of building the app from the database. So off the bat, both FlutterFlow and Bubble have free trials, so you're able to learn how to use the tools and build with the tools to get started for free. Then they have monthly plans, which is going to vary between, as you can see with Bubble, 29, 119. You're probably going to need like a starter or growth plan to get started. And then similar here, 30 to 70 here for standard to pro. The big difference is that with Bubble, you also are going to pay for something called workload units, which is essentially, think of it as a workload unit is charged when someone does something on your app. And the more like backend logic, for example, that your app is running, the more workload units you're going to use. So if you run out of these included workload units in your plan, you would have to pay an additional charge to buy more workload units. Whereas with FlutterFlow, you don't have any of that because you're going to be paying a separate bill for using Firebase or Supabase or whatever your database is, maybe Xano that you're using. Those other tools such as Firebase are going to have costs, but it's likely going to be a lot less than what Bubble is charging here for their workload units. So overall, you'll probably end up paying less using FlutterFlow, at least if your app really scales. Now, I personally haven't had an issue with the workload units in Bubble. I know that's something a lot of people are concerned about. I run multiple apps on Bubble, and I haven't had an issue with the pricing there. There might be some types of apps, such as like a social media app that has tons of usage, but not a lot of maybe monetization in the beginning or for a while, where the costs could get pretty high if you don't have monetization built into your app. So it's just something to be aware of, and something that I can talk more about in another video. But that's kind of the difference between pricing in terms of FlutterFlow and Bubble. So hopefully that's a helpful kind of overview there. Something else that you're going to want to consider when you're choosing between FlutterFlow and Bubble is the ability to export your code. So this is something that FlutterFlow allows you to do that Bubble does not allow you to do. So with FlutterFlow, you can actually download all of the code that FlutterFlow has written for you, and you can take that code and then you can give it to a developer, and then that developer can write code on top of that code. Whereas with Bubble, you are not able to export the code. So you have to use their proprietary platform. So this is something to keep in mind, and it is an advantage for FlutterFlow if that's something that is important to you. So hopefully that was a helpful overview of the pros and cons of each platform, what their similarities are, what their differences are. If you have any additional questions about any of these platforms, just leave a comment below and I'll do my best to answer them. If you want to learn how to build in these platforms, check out NoCode MBA, nocode.mba, click the link in the description, and you can go to our Bubble course or our FlutterFlow course, where we have courses to help you learn how to build with both of these tools. Our FlutterFlow course is actually coming really soon, so if you click and you don't see it quite yet, it's going to be uploaded soon to NoCode MBA. We also have Building Apps with AI, which is a course that covers a lot of building with Bubble and connecting to AI APIs such as Stable Diffusion, OpenAI, and a lot more. So that might be of interest to you as well. So again, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.